episode, and I'm not really spoiling. I just want to put it out there for people that are like myself, who like the Bourne series or anything related. And also, I haven't read the books. Like, I have read majority of the Bourne Supremacy, the Bourne Ultimate, all the Bourne books, because I love Robert Ludlum as an author. And then I saw the movies. Now, obviously, the movies weren't as good as the books in that case, so I'm assuming that's how it is right now with the Tom Clancy series. Nonetheless, I binge-watch both seasons when they were released. The latest season, season 2, was released a few weeks ago. I already finished it. And I think I've come to terms with the fact that it's not my favorite, but I did binge-watch it. It did hold my attention. And if you like that kind of espionage, thriller, spy kind of stuff, then it's a great series for you to check out. And that is, again, on Amazon Prime Video. We are in currently in November, but in December, another Amazon Prime wonderful show is coming back. The season 3 of Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. So that's another reason why I resubscribed to Amazon Prime, because I love Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. And I'm excited to kind of round out the binging part. Obviously, everybody and their brother has binge-watched all of Stranger Things. So, connection to Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Now, Carrie Elwes, who played the mayor of Season 3 in Stranger Things, has also added to the cast of Marvelous Mrs. Maisel on Amazon Prime, which, excuse me, I'm excited about, because Carrie Elwes is a great actor, and if he's in one of the most iconic classic movies of all time, which is The Princess Bride, and a lot of other things. So I'm excited to see how he's incorporated in the storyline of Season 3 of Marvelous Mrs. Maisel. Now, if you don't know the premise of Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, it takes place in the 40s, I believe. And it's chronicling the start of, like, well, that's her name, but her career as a stand-up comic in a world where women weren't taken seriously, as seriously in the, well, they still aren't, but that's a whole nother episode that's been tackled on this podcast. But it talks about her family and her family's come to terms with her pursuing a career in stand-up comedy, and all of the characters and historical figures, like a Lenny Bruce, and that it's just a wonderful show. It's feminist without being feminist. I mean, Fleabag's kind of feminist, but it's not in-your-face feminist. They're just brilliant shows. So again, that's on Amazon Prime coming in December, so I'm looking forward to that season 3. Now, to kind of go back to Netflix, since I've already mentioned it, because of Stranger Things being one of the top binged watch shows pretty much of all time on Netflix. Of course, season 3 was great. We watched it all. It was released on July 4th, and we watched it that entire day. Now, I will have to say, my personal preference, I like season 2 over season 3. It was great, but I believe there's just something about season 2 that held my interest even more than season 1. I don't know. I love Stranger Things. That is great. But another show that's coming out, I believe, December or the beginning of 2020, one other show, another season of a show that was quite surprisingly good, is the show called You. Now, I believe I've mentioned it on previous Binge episodes, but You is this intense show that was actually originally released on Lifetime and then added to Netflix. And by the time it added to Netflix, it became a phenomenon because all of us start to binge, which tends to be the trend nowadays with everybody cutting the cord. But it's this, and it was a book itself. I didn't read the book, so I can't compare the book to the show, but I was compelled. It's a creepy show. It's basically about a stalker situation, and how creepy that can get, and how dangerous that can be. I think the brilliance, because we've seen that story over and over again about stalkers and situations, but I think the brilliance about You was the fact that they incorporated it into modern times. So it's basically, they incorporated, you know, with social media, how you're easily stalked by people, and which makes it even creepier, but it's just like a kind of open your eyes to how you are online and how you live your life. And I'm excited for season 2 to come out. That I believe it's coming out in December, and if it's not December, it's the beginning of 2020, so that's exciting. I'm curious, now, I don't know if I mentioned this on the previous Binge What episodes, but I think I did, maybe in the last one. The show Bodyguard, which is, again, another British show, BBC show, fucking brilliant. Now, I haven't heard any updates on a season 2. I do remember hearing that they were gonna do a season 2 because it was such a phenomenon on Netflix, again, but I haven't heard anything since I really hope they make a season two to that show. As I've mentioned, and I really wanted to avoid mentioning, but I cannot mention because I've done previous episodes, the show Lucifer, they're shooting the fifth and final season right now, and the recent news is that it's going to be broken into two sets of eight episodes, which is usually the Netflix formula anyway, but that's exciting because it's a 16 episode final end to the story. They're currently shooting, they're in the middle of shooting that season. If you have not and yet have watched the show, you will be surprised at how fucking great it is. It appeals to all ages, all genders. Check it out. Yes, the name might throw you, but once you start the show, you would be surprised in how intrigued of how well the writing, acting, and all-around aesthetic that is that show. What else to binge watch? I did mention Loma. So, I mean, another great thing is I've mentioned a couple docuseries. There's some other docuseries. I think there's this one docuseries. It's in limited release on Netflix. It's called Explained. It's great. It has these little short episodes about specific topics that may intrigue you in terms of life, like anxiety or the meaning of dreams or other such that's intriguing. Now, I will have to go back to a series that was totally binge watchable seasons ago, but this seventh season is so hard. Okay, so I fucking love the show Orange is the New Black. However, I always fine with the ending and season six being the final season. But somehow, a fan outcry brought forth a seventh season, which, to me, was unnecessary. And knowing all of that, I felt the cast and crew rushed into writing and shooting the season. And the season's been out for months, and I'm only halfway through. It is so